Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2. We have just arrived in the lower town. We marked... It's a long story. We want to get down here anyway, because we have to meet up with Remy, the former swashbuckling rat, now a member of Secret Service or something like that. I don't remember. But anyway, in order to get down here, we had to embark on a mission for the guard, which was marking a barrel from the upper town to see if it is delivered through a crane, thereby passing through customs down to the lower town. So if we find our little barrel with the X mark, or I think it was an X mark, then we have the evidence. So anyway, let's take a look around here. Lamp.
Just over a year ago when I stood in front of this gate for the first time, Mr. Shieldhound wouldn't let me into the upper town to see the Archmage. I had to earn the right to an audience first by becoming a mage.
Right. That was over a year ago, huh?
I've never understood this strange separation between the upper and the lower town. The upper town is like a town within the town, with its own walls and private gate. And people from the lower town work up there, but at night, they return to the lower town because they can't afford the upper town rents. My one apple a day wouldn't get me far up there either. Luckily, I can live in the school for free. I'm sure Shieldhand won't let me back into the upper town until I have proof of Bill's bootlegging.
Oh, they had three different things to say there.
I'm sure Shieldhand won't let me...
Shut up.
I'm sure...
Oh, now we're... Okay, now it's ignoring that. We're just clicking on the gate. Never mind. Oh, there's an outhouse here.
Bill also built the outhouse. Remy says he's rented this entire strip along the town wall. Maybe he couldn't bear the thought of leaving his stand unattended for a few minutes a day. There's a big padlock on the door. If I didn't know who the outhouse belonged to, I'd find that a tad strange. I bet you could pick up the key from Bill for a small fee.
Right, he's going to charge you for that too. This is his stall.
Bill's stall. During the day, he sells stuff from the upper town that you can't normally get down here. Most traders and all the nearby farmers sell their goods at the lower town's big market. But Bill claimed this spot here as it's the only place he can sneak in the upper town contraband using his crane. Normally, the town wakes at the crack of dawn. Then Bill is on the job, selling his goods until it gets dark. He works hard. But whether he'll open so early tomorrow morning, I just don't know. The barricade may keep most of his customers away.
I can talk to Bill? I thought he was up there.
Psst! Bill!
Oh, we are talking to him up there.
Who's there? And what do you want?
This is Anton Shieldhand. I want to talk about my bribe money.
It's me! Mr. Shieldhand. I want to talk to you about my bribe. Or lack of, to be precise.
Why do you call yourself Mr. Shieldhand?
Because I am... Anton! Anton Shieldhand is my name. And I... want a bribe.
Peachy, is that you? It's bloody dark down there.
Yes, it's me, Petey.
Why are you putting on a funny voice all of a sudden? You really are a crazy dog. So what can I do for my favourite errand boy?
I want smuggled goods.
I would like... smuggled goods.
Can you be a little bit more
different
specific?
Voice every time. I'd like a pony.
I don't know why, but recently I've had this funny little pony floating around inside my head.
Pony? I can't help you there. Was there anything else?
Sure, I need a barrel of brandy.
I need a barrel of brandy for the inn.
No problem. What's the password?
Oops. Password? What password?
Password? What password?
The secret password. I can't just offer illegal goods to anyone, especially as I don't have any.
Oh, that password. All right. The password is...
Do you even know the password?
What about you? Do you even know the password?
Of course, but that's hardly the point.
Should I buy my illegal goods from just anyone?
All right, then. The password is marmalade.
The password is marmalade.
No, it's not. I just wanted to wind you up.
Sir?
Well, what's the real password?
Fluffy bunnies?
Is it fluffy bunnies?
What? No.
Construct additional pylons?
Are you just guessing?
No.
What's the password?
I don't know the password.
I don't know the password.
Why not? Aren't you Petey? Step into the light.
Yes, I am. But I forgot the password.
Ha! That's just like you. Ask in the inn. The owner knows it.
Fine.
He's really trusting.
Psst! Bill!
Petey, is that you? What's the password?
I still don't know it.
Ah, then go to the inn and get it. A trader must have principles. Dirty deals only among friends.
Toolbox.
A wooden box full of old tools. Some sort of metal clamps, a hammer, some wire. Probably Bill uses the stuff to maintain his stand. I'll take the hammer.
Okay.
A hammer for hammering.
Right. Loading platform.
So this is where the crane comes down. And up there's Bill sitting on his crates.
Okay. Oh, can we knock on the gate? What are we going to do that for?
Well, how's it going?
This thing isn't as easy as we thought. It's a bit tricky.
Then put some effort into it. You don't want to spend the night in the lower town, do you?
But...
As soon as the Mark Barrel turns up in the lower town, I've got Bill over a... barrel. And I'll let you back in again. Not before.
There's no sense in that. Only once the marked barrel of alcohol is down here does Shieldhand have the evidence he needs.
I just wanted to bother him again. Let's go further down. Chez L'Ogre. Stairs.
Sea stone has grown quite organically over the centuries. There are doors behind which there are only walls, staircases that lead to nowhere. Maybe a house was supposed to go here, but the builder changed his mind.
Who knows? Oh, there's the drain where we met, what's his name? Swashbuckler Rat. Remy.
This is one of the entrances to the underground world of the rats. Rats represent one of the town's largest population groups. But many don't think of them as real people and they don't have many rights. Remy and the Archmage have been trying to change that for a long time. But some think that the rats entered the town illegally and consider them vermin.
So it's one of the drains.
When Seastone was almost a ghost town at the end of the war, the rats were unable to find enough food. I helped them. We've been best friends ever since. But since Remy became head of intelligence, I don't see him as often as I used to. So he's doing a good job.
Okay.
At the moment, more people live outside the town than inside it. Most of them are refugees. There were days when the wagons were lined up nose back to bumper, and the road was full of them as far as the eye could see. This cart's been here a long time. Strange it wasn't used for either the temporary tent city or the barricades.
Yes, yes.
The inn used to be here on the right, and on the left was Master Marcus's mage school. After the war, so many people came to the town that we needed a larger inn. Master Marcus was happy to sell his old mage school. Change is good, he told me.
Oh, barricaded. Can't get
the
out.
First and most impressive barricade I've ever seen. The protesters took everything they could find and piled it up to make a huge wall. No one is getting through without a troll.
Oh, is a hatch? Yes, look at hatch.
This looks like a hatch.
Well, because it is a hatch.
Hello?
Aloha.
Ah.
Are you talking to the enemy?
Who are you?
Who are you?
My name is...
Shh. If you tell an agent of the government our real names, you'll endanger the entire organization.
His name is...
What do you want to call us?
My name is John. No, Paul. Next to me is, J-Stop.
Your name is Paul? But you're a woman.
Gender is just one of the fictions indoctrinated by the patriarchal society.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Righto. Did you build the barricade?
Did you build the barricade?
Aye, that's right.
Do you like it?
Yeah, it's beautiful. But it kind of blocks the whole street, doesn't it?
I think that's the idea.
We're going to dry you lot out till you give us what we want.
But the upper town is supplied by airships.
We won't move an inch until you stand starving and freezing before us.
But we've got plenty of food. And if my rabbit sheep didn't always take my bed, I wouldn't freeze either.
I told you it doesn't work like that.
We're protesting here, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Oh, we're not in Lower Town yet? What are you protesting for?
What are you protesting about, then?
We're protesting against exploitation, against discrimination, against poverty, and against the destruction of the environment.
All that, huh?
Wow! Those are all important issues. What do you plan on doing?
We're already doing something.
We are demanding that things change.
We've made a petition.
And we're putting together a list of demands.
We're still working on the wording. Problems with the neutrality guidelines.
How far have you got?
Dear brothers, stroke sisters in arms, other forms of resistance are available. Fellow countrymen, countrywomen, country transsexuals, country gender nonconformists.
Getting back to the whole making a change thing.
If you want to make a difference, you can write like on a piece of paper and pass it through the hatch.
Like.
Then everyone will know you support our cause.
What is this, your Facebook page? One of your people is in jail, right?
I talked to a prisoner in the upper town. He's one of yours, isn't he?
A victim of the state's power. Our first martyr.
He's not dead yet. And if he got the cake, he'll be back with us soon.
The cake? Who will you support in the election?
If you're for justice and change, you'll probably be voting for Archmage Alistair, right?
The election's a joke. One corrupt politician replacing another. And behind the scenes, it's always the same people pulling the strings.
That may be true of the council leader, but the Archmage...
Big Mana's got them eating out their hands.
Exactly. The magic industrial multinational that was responsible for the war.
So, you're entering your own candidate?
That's pure daft. There's no point. We're doing the only thing that will lead to success. We're protesting.
Right. So what exactly are your demands?
Maybe I can pass on some of your demands to the Archmage, and we can see what can be done.
We demand that no one in Aventasia should ever be poorer than average.
Hmm. Isn't that mathematically impossible?
Not at all. If every resident got exactly the same amount of gold, then no one is poorer than the average.
Hmm. But if everyone gets the same amount of gold without having to do anything for it, why would anyone bother to earn the gold in the first place?
Only someone who belongs to the rich elite could ask something like that.
This game is all of a sudden getting very political. I want to go to the lower town.
Everything all right in the lower town?
Couldn't be better. The fire of protest is stoking up hell. People are being drawn closer together by a common noble goal.
And because of a lack of space.
Yeah.
Wished.
Why did you set the barricade here and not at the gate? That would have given you loads of extra space.
And the inn would have been on our side too.
Our barricade is more visible this way. The elite should quake at the sight of our resolve.
I don't think they're doing that.
You're clearly trying to drive a wedge between us, Agent. See? The fat cats are trying to sabotage us. They're afraid. That's a good sign.
Have to be going.
May the protest never end.
Yeah. Viva la revolution. Okay. Okay, I'll be back in a second. Okay, I'm back. There are a few things here. A bucket and a fireplace? You call this a fireplace? That's a brazier.
Someone has put a bucket of water next to the fire pit. Security isn't normally a priority in Seastone. But with all these wooden houses, I'm glad to see an exception.
Except for fires?
The water in the bucket's frozen to ice.
Well, it's not that secure then, is it?
The water in the
fireplace.
Usually citizens and visitors to the inn warm up by the fireplace on cold nights. Paper, wood, everything's here, except for someone looking to warm up. Usually citizens and visitors to the inn. Paper.
Okay. Light the fire.
A small fire spell can't hurt. Ignifaxius ignisfero.
Oh, I can look down, too. You can see that.
The houses in Seastone are pretty cramped together. And down there somewhere, there's a city made of tents and boards. The Archmage is working hard to give people hope after the devastation of the war. Every day you can hear the people down there making music and singing until late at night. They dance, practice dwarf tossing, and hold spelling bees.
Dwarf tossing, huh?
They know how to entertain themselves. But one day the mood will turn. There might not be enough beer, or too much. Either would be a problem.
Suppose so.
The fire is warm and bright, a welcome respite on a cold night. The fire is... The magic slate from Master Alistair.
What can I do for you?
Tell me about golems.
What can you tell me about golems?
Golems are powerful magical beings. They are made of clay or stone, have unbelievable strength, and can work non-stop.
They're also flesh golems.
Are they living beings or machines?
They are tools for mages. They do heavy physical work for them. The mage inserts a piece of paper with commands written on it in its mouth, and the golem carries out these commands.
Where can I get my hands on a golem? I've always said it, golem.
Ah, where can I get a golem? Or do I have to build one myself?
Golems are very rare and expensive, but their construction isn't difficult. In principle.
In principle?
The body of a golem is a kind of statue of stone, clay, or other inorganic materials. In order to bring the lifeless statue to life, a spell written in magic ink must be placed in its mouth.
And nobody knows this formula.
That is not correct. I know the spell.
But how? Ah, Master Alistair! He must have sensed that I'd need a golem to help me. The body should be easy enough to build, and you know the spell, so what's the problem?
The spell must be written in magic ink. Some of the ingredients are very rare.
Ah, piffle, I'm good at finding rare things.
What do I need for the golem's body?
What's the best way to go about building a golem's body?
A golem needs a torso of stone, clay, loam, or similar. It also needs strong arms in order to carry heavy weights.
And a couple of strong legs to move around on.
Correct. The head of a golem must be made of clay and needs a mouth in which command notes can be inserted.
That means I'll have to make the head myself. Unless I just happen to find a finished golem head lying around somewhere.
What do I need for the golem's body?
What's the best way to go about building a golem's body?
A golem needs a torso of stone, clay, loam, or similar. It also needs strong arms in order to carry heavy weights.
And a couple of strong...
Correct.
Sorry, we already asked us. Okay. What is this magic golem ink made of?
What ingredients are needed for this magic ink? Does it have to be brewed like a magic potion? Like, stir three times to the left and then four quick turns to the right?
I did that last time.
I hope not.
No. A simple mixing of the ingredients is sufficient. However, precise quantities are crucial.
Okay. What are the ingredients?
Exactly 2 centiliters of crocodile tears. Exactly 12 drops of dragon sweat.
12?
And exactly 1 seastone small ounces of soot.
What in the world is 12? And dragon sweat? It's kind of hard to make a dragon sweat.
Correct. Dragon sweat is very rare.
I'll think of something. Can you list the ingredients for me?
No problem. You can see the list by looking at me in the inventory.
What do you mean, looking at you in the inventory?
Exactly.
You'll manage.
Show me the list.
Show me the list.
Right. Just what you said.
What can I do for you?
I might have some more questions for you later.
And I might answer.
That's always good to hear. Good to know, etc. Alright, shall we enter the pub? These guys have anything more to say? I lit your fireplace.
Yes?
I need clay. I have to go out by the tower, the lower town, to get it.
I need clay to mold something. There's lots of it just outside the town. Could you please let me through?
Aye. That would really suit you, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
But we're not going to let you through.
Wah.
Could you maybe pass me a lump of clay through the barricade, then?
What do we get in return?
Are you doing deals with the enemy?
We don't make deals with dirty capitalists.
That's more like it.
If I had some clay, I could give you my support.
I don't want the clay for myself. I want to use it to support your cause.
How's that?
I could strengthen the barricade with the clay.
If you give me just a few handfuls of clay, I could really improve the barricade.
Really?
Sure. I can smear the clay between the boards from here and the sunlight would bake it hard as rock.
I think that sounds pretty good.
Oh, this one will work. Okay.
The barricade is stable enough already. The spirit of friendship built it, and the chains of suppression are holding it together.
Huh. But there are holes everywhere here, which need to be sealed. Magic could seep through the little gaps, or gas, or something like that.
Perhaps you're right. But I still don't trust you.
Have to be going.
May the protest never end.
I didn't get to choose the other options.
I find them both quite entertaining, but I don't know what I'd talk to them about.
Talk about we'd make a statue for them. Now let's go inside the Chez L'Ogre. Oh, I know them. From the first game. There he is. Let's take care of everything else first. Some jacket.
Someone forgot their jacket. Or left it hanging there while they take a nap upstairs. That would be risky. The crime rate in this town is at an all-time high. Someone forgot their jacket. That would be... Hopefully I can sleep in my own bed tonight. A bed here at the inn would overtax the contents of my wallet.
The only thing you have is an apple. How's that going to fit in your wallet? We know them.
Wow! A two-headed ogre. I've heard of those.
Oh, Nate met them.
I never thought I'd actually ever see one of those in real life. Or smell it.
That's right, we met them as neat. Let's look at everything else first. Converted role-playing machine?
Master Marcus and Bill eventually had enough of this strange role-playing apparatus. I thought Master Marcus had outgrown his love of fantasy worlds, but now there's a live role-play. I'm worried about him. Eventually, he might spend all of his time in his fantasy role-play world of bicycles, tax returns, microwaves, and branded soft drinks, and forget the real world entirely. The thing makes a good fireplace, and the boar's head from the old inn looks good there too. I must say that, overall, I really like this pub. I hope that in a few days I can celebrate the election victory here with Remy and the Archmage.
Oh. Oh no, I had Mr. Block. Crap. Let's look at the postcard.
Swinging Seastone, the town that never sleeps. This postcard was clearly sent before the war. Even the Mage School Tower is in its proper place.
Take. Oh, neat.
I can't enter the upper town, the gate's locked.
Oh, we can use it to just get there?
The first clues that demons were in the cameras was that those photographed made strange grimaces they would never make in reality. A number of the students in the graduating class of 1462 is written in ornate script above the image.
Shot.
A postcard from Seastone. It can help me get from A to B more quickly.
That's great. I'm already here, huh? Let's look at the notice.
A sheet of paper with lots of paragraphs in small type. It says, license in law at the top. Rules for different drinking games, maybe.
Nope.
Article 1, paragraph 1, drink with sense. If sense is not available, drink without. And here, article 6, paragraph 5. The feeding of mugwais after midnight is expressly forbidden.
Of course.
That makes sense. Article 14, paragraph 2. The host is not required to serve vampires. This seems to be a long list of rules that apply to inns and their guests. How practical. This way you can check at any time to ensure that any freewheeling party still conform to local ordinances. That's one less worry. There are a whole bunch of articles here. The paper is covered in writing so small and closely packed that it's difficult enough to decipher the text sober. Article 9, paragraph 1. Dwarven ale may only be served in specially secure underground bunkers. Luckily, they don't know about the cellar master back home in the White Ridge Mountains and our dwarven ale experiment. There are a whole bunch of article...
Our favorite. That's the notice. Yeah. There's something else over here. Oh, this table.
I've had so much to do in school I haven't been here since the reopening. It turned out well, even if it is a little bit weird. Like the bartender. Zzz.
Bartender. Zzz. Alright. Headmaster Block.
Headmaster Block seems to be counting gold. Lots of gold. I wonder where he got it.
Okay, well, stay tuned for next episode when we talk with Headmaster Block, the Two-Headed Ogre, and Remy, the King of Thieves. See you next time, and bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.